Hey KW agents, I hope you're doing well. I wanted to create a quick video that walks you through really everything that you can do with a contact in command, which I know might seem pretty elementary or pretty basic, but I just wanted to go through just some cool things that you guys can do. So first of all, we're going to get into contacts. All right, so once we're looking at contacts, you've got a couple different things of, first of all, how we're actually looking at the contacts. So one thing that we can do is come up here and filter. And so we can go in and filter by maybe tags that the system has or custom tags. We can also go in and sort by lead sources. We can sort by last contacted. We can sort by last visited, date of birth, so all of these different things. And then what you can do is, let's say that I have leads, right? And so I want to say, yep, apply. So I want to make sure that I'm always looking at anybody that I said is a lead. And maybe this is the way that I always want to see my database when I first log in. That's considered a smart view. So I could come down here and I could say create smart view, and we would call this leads. And then I can set that as my default smart view, which means every time that I log into command and I'm looking at my contacts, it's going to show me this first. Now let's say I log into command and I don't want to see that, I want to see everything. I would just come up here where it says filters on, and I would go in and I would clear all the filters and then hit apply. And then it takes me back to where I can do that. And then I can come up here anytime and choose from my smart views that I've created and look at that. Another thing that you can do that's a relatively new update is I can customize columns. So over here on the left, it'll tell you every single column that you can pull up. So a lot of times people really want to know birthdays. That's a way that they really engage with their contacts. I could choose that and I could have that show up on one of my columns. And then once I decide these are all the columns that I want to see, I can decide what I want to see first. So let's say I really want to see how I've tagged them. I want that to be first, or I want their phone number, or really whatever you guys want. You can do that, hit apply, and then it'll switch the order of that. So that's how we can just maybe customize our view, because again, we want you to use command the way that you would like to use it. So just some functionality that you guys have for that. So let's take a look at an actual contact and talk about some different things. So first of all, when we go into a contact, you'll see that this contact has an L next to it. That means it's a lead. I marked it as a lead right here. This contact has a health score of 88%, so there's different things you can add to a contact that'll get you that higher health score. And then down here, I've got their phone number as well as their email address. So if you have a Mac, or even if you have a Windows computer, it would be a different app, but if you have a Mac and you're able to use FaceTime, you can actually click directly on the number and it'll pop up and say, how would you like to contact them? I'll choose call. Now for me, it's gonna pick FaceTime. If I had a Windows machine, I'd be able to choose an app of how I would like to call them. And we've got other tutorials on that. So you're basically calling them directly through your computer. It's gonna use your phone, or on a Mac, it'll use your FaceTime here. But what I actually think is kind of better than that is it pops up with this little box where I would want to add the interactions of the phone call with them. So I will say that I had a call, today is the third, and then we'll just say this is a test phone call, add to timeline, and then that pops up as an activity that I've actually done with that customer that I have. Underneath that, you've got neighborhoods, and so we're all pretty familiar with this, but it's gonna pull in a neighborhood based off of locations. Then we can add additional neighborhoods. Underneath that, you've got additional contact information, description, birth date, all of that. Then over here on the right, you've got the timeline, so that's the default view. We're gonna see all the activity that we've ever done with this contact. And then underneath that, you'll see opportunities. So if this is a buyer or a seller or a potential buyer or seller, and you've created an opportunity, you'll see that underneath here. You'll also be able to create an opportunity based off of this contact right from here. Then underneath that, we'll have smart plans that this contact is associated with right now. If we wanted to take them off of one, we would just hit the trash, and that allows them to unsubscribe. We can also add to other smart plans here. And then underneath that, we've got tasks. So you can go in and create a task and add a task to any contact. Those will show up here as well as through Kelly and on your dashboard. And then we've got a notes section. So you want to make sure that you're really adding as many notes as possible every time that you communicate with them. And that's where you'll see these. Then underneath that, we've got saved searches. So if they're using your app or if they are really using your website and they've created a saved search, you'll see all of that up here. So I hope that's helpful. That's just kind of the contacts at a glance to some cool things, cool functionality that you guys can use that for. So I think you might have a little bit of time on your hands now. Make sure that you're really getting that contact database scrubbed and that you're reaching out to everybody and just checking in on them. So like always, we're here to help. If you have any questions or need help with anything, please don't hesitate to reach out, and I hope to see you all soon.